Ronnie said finally. What is it? But he knew.
You tell us, Metaxa growled sourly.
It's an intelligent life form, Ronnie blurted. Why has it been kept secret?
Let's go on back upstairs, Metaxa sighed.
Back in his office, he said,
Now I go into my speech. Shut up for a while.
He poured himself a drink, not offering one to the other two.
Ronnie, he said, man isn't alone in the galaxy. There's other intelligent life, dangerously intelligent.
In spite of himself, Ronnie reacted in amusement. That little creature down there? The size of a small monkey? As soon as he said it, he realized the ridiculousness of his statement. Metaxa grunted.
Obviously, size means nothing. That little fella down there was picked up by one of our Space Force's scouts over a century ago. How long he'd been drifting through space, we don't know. Possibly only months, but possibly hundreds of centuries. But however long, he's proof that man is not alone in the galaxy. And we have no way of knowing when the expanding human race will come up against this other intelligence, and whoever it was fighting.
But, Ronnie protested, you're assuming they're aggressive. Perhaps coming in contact with these aliens will be the best thing that ever happened to man. Possibly that little fellow down there is the most benevolent creature ever evolved. Metaxa looked at him strangely.
Let's hope so, he said. However, when found, he was in what must have been a one-man scout. He was dead, and his craft was blasted and torn, obviously from some sort of weapons fire. His scout was obviously a military craft, highly equipped with what could only be weapons. Most of them so damaged, our engineers haven't been able to figure them out. To the extent they have been able to reconstruct them, they're scared silly. Nope, there's no two ways about it. Our little rabbit-sized intelligence down in the vault was killed in an interplanetary conflict. And sooner or later, Ronnie, man, in his explosion into the stars, is going to run into either or both of the opponents in that conflict.